Now that we understand kernels and null spaces, we're going to look at ranges and column spaces. And ranges refer to linear transformations, and column spaces refer to matrices. And they're going to be related. So if you have a linear transformation from a vector space V to a vector space W, the range is a set of all possible outputs. You take everything in V and feed it to your linear transformation, and what comes out is your range. So the simplest example is where if V and W are R3 and L of X is the identity map, well, everything is the output because every element in R3 is L of something. It's L of itself. A less trivial example comes if you think of V as being the quadratic polynomials and W as being the cubic polynomials. Then if you take L of F to be the L to be the map that takes a polynomial and multiplies it by t, so L of 1 is t, L of t is t squared, L of t squared is t cubed, then the range is everything of the form something times t plus something times t squared plus something times t cubed. Because you got that by taking something plus something times t plus something times t squared and multiplying it by t. Okay. I claim that the range, the way we defined it, was as a subset of W. It's all possible outputs, and outputs are in W. But in fact, it's a subspace. The point is that anything that's in the range can be written as L of something that's in V. So L of X is a typical element of the range, and L of Y is another typical element of the range. And you wonder, is there some in the range? Well, sure, because L of X plus L of Y is L of X plus Y. So that's in the range of L. The range is closed under addition. And a multiple of something in the range, well, that's L of CX. So that's also in the range. And 0 is L of 0. So that's also in the range. Since it's closed under addition, under scalar multiplication, and since it contains zero, it's a subspace. Now let's switch gears and look at matrices. If somebody hands us an M by N matrix, one of the things we like to look at is the column space. And the column space is, by definition, all possible linear combinations of the columns. But remember the definition of matrix multiplication. AX is X1 times the first column, plus X2 times the second column, plus X3 times the third column, and so on. The set of everything that can be written as AX is a linear combination of the columns. And every linear combination of the columns can be written as AX. So another way to think of this is the set of all things of the form AX. And that's starting to look an awful lot like the definition of our range. A range is a set of all possible L of X's. The column space is a set of all possible A times X's. Now, we already worked out a basis for the column space. Those are the pivot columns of A. You take A, you row reduce it, you figure out where the pivots are, and then you go back to the original matrix and take those pivot columns. So that means that the dimension of the column space has got to be the rank of A, the number of pivots. And in particular, since we already said the dimension of the null space was n minus the rank, this means the dimension of the column space plus the dimension of the null space is always equal to n. So what do matrices have to do with linear transformations? Well, bases and coordinates. If you pick a basis B for V and a basis D for W, you get our usual picture. The B basis makes V look like Rn and makes W look like Rm. And we have this matrix that takes coordinates of inputs and gives you coordinates of outputs. Now, let's look at where things go. If you consider all possible Vs and you take L of all the possible Vs, you get the range of L. And then you apply the coordinate map to that, and you get the coordinates of the range of L. On the other hand, if you went the other way, you started with V and you took the coordinates of everything in V, you'd get all of Rm. And then you take all of Rm and you multiply it by LdB, and you get the column space of LdB. So what we've just shown is that the column space of LdB is the same as the coordinates of the range. Remember, the null space of LdB was the coordinates of the kernel of L. The column space is the coordinates of the range of L. And how do we get a basis for the range? Well, we need to figure out a basis for the column space, and we say the vectors whose coordinates form a basis for the column space, that's a basis for the range. But what are those? Those are columns of L, which is to say, and the coordinates of the columns of L are exactly, the columns of L are just the coordinates of L of Bi. So our basis for the range is L of Bi, where we pick which basis vectors we use. We pick the basis vectors that correspond to pivot columns. So let's do an example. Oh, so in particular, the dimension of the range is the same as the dimension of the column space, and that's the rank of the matrix. And we will define the rank of a linear transformation to be the rank of the matrix, or the dimension of the range, same thing. And in particular, we have what's called the dimension theorem, which says for any linear transformation, if you take the dimension of the kernel plus the dimension of the range, you get the dimension of the space V that you're mapping from. Okay, finally, let's look at an example. In our example, this is going to be our multiplication by T example. In our example, we have V being quadratic polynomials with a basis of 1, T, and T squared. W is cubic polynomials with a basis of 1, t, t squared, and t cubed. And L is multiplication by t. Now, how do you get the matrix? The matrix of it, you apply L of B1. L of 1 is t, so that's the coordinates of t is 0, 1, 0, 0. L of t is t squared, whose coordinates are 0, 0, 1, 0. L of t squared is t cubed, whose coordinates are 0, 0, 0, 1. Well, you notice that's already in reduced row echelon, that's already in row echelon form. And so you see that there are pivots in all three columns. Actually, not quite row echelon form because there's a row of zeros at the top, but there are still pivots in all three columns. And so that means that our basis for range of L is we apply L to all three basis vectors, L of B1, L of B2, L of B3, which is to say t, t squared, and t cubed. So the range is all polynomials that you get as linear combinations of t, t squared, and t cubed.